Dean Yurtsos, faculty, parents, distinguished guests, and last but certainly not least, graduates of the University of Southern California Viterbi School of Engineering, it is my absolute honor to be here with you today to celebrate this milestone achievement. Graduates, you are now part of the rich history of this great university. A history that has been built upon a commitment to educating future leaders in the classical tradition of excellence and purity of purpose, for discovering new technologies and finding solutions to the world's most pressing problems. A commencement is a culmination as well as an inauguration, a closing of one chapter and the start of the next. Some of you thought this day would never come. Others of you feel like it just all happened too fast. And the faculty, as you see them sitting here, are just filled with amazement as they reflect on the transformation that has occurred within each member of this class. Today, you stand on your launch pad. As you receive your diploma, you will be lifting off for life into the orbit of your choosing. I'm confident that all of you will soar to great achievement as you fulfill your own personal and professional missions. As you embark on this next chapter of your life with a new graduate degree in engineering, fully prepared to make your mark on society, I hope that you realize that a degree from Viterbi represents a remarkable investment that will pay dividends again and again. In addition to being a member of the Trojan family, you are now a leader in the intellectual, cultural, and spiritual fabric of the world. Indeed, as Dean Yurtsos has said, the world is being recreated and reimagined like never before at an astonishing speed. Now you have the opportunity to set the direction and ultimate goals for serving and changing our society. So I commend and congratulate all of the degree candidates today because you are going out into a world that needs you. Graduates, you will define the future of engineering, the future of our rapidly evolving tech industries, and the future of our planet. Today, I'm going to take a few moments to address the challenges, the changes, and the opportunities that the world holds for you and indeed for all of us. But before I move on to that topic, I have a confession to make. I was advised to keep my remarks brief because you have a reputation for being mobile natives, social media superstars, and I suspect a few of you are looking forward to the celebrations as well. So I have the following Twitter-ready version of the commencement address. And you should feel free to tweet, blog, post, snap, Tinder, whatever it is that you're going to do. As a result of my 40 years career, here are 10 important pieces of advice I would offer to graduates in this changing world, starting with number 10. Get a job. It's been fun. You got to leave here. You're not a student anymore. You got to have a plan, and plans take money. Number 9, anticipate change and embrace it. The world is going to change again and again. It used to be we'd say you can't avoid death and taxes. I would tell you, you can't avoid death, taxes, and change. Number 8, be a source of solutions and new ideas. It's easy to be a critic. It's easy to come in after the fact and say you coulda, you shoulda. It's really, really hard to be the person that contributes to figuring out what needs to be done next. Number 7, please vote. We need your help in choosing our elected leaders. Number 6, Make peace, not war. It's what I call conservation of enemies. You can disagree without being disagreeable. Number five, do what you love. Stay connected to your passions, your dreams, and your beliefs. Number four, ask good questions and listen for the answers. Get the facts. Avoid truth decay and draw your own conclusions. Number three, think globally. When someone on the other side of the world sneezes, it won't be long before someone in your backyard catches a cold. And number two, say thank you. Give back more than you receive. And I'm going to ask you to do that right now by giving a round of applause to the people who helped you get here today. And finally, number one, always have a plan to be self-sustaining. In other words, get a job. I'm not sure where Blake Stacy is, but your mom in particular told me she wanted you to get that message today. So, okay, that's the social media friendly version of my address. I understand that some of you may suffer from nomophobia. You know, that's a Wall Street Journal documented anxiety which comes from being separated from your phone. So if you need to get back to Spotify, I understand. But in all seriousness, I do have a few more important messages that I want to share with you today and hope you take them to heart. So let's talk briefly about the challenges and the opportunities that you will face. The great challenge and simultaneous opportunity is that you will, during your life, be faced with infinite possibilities. Let's go back to 1960 for just a moment, when then President John F. Kennedy promised to lead America to new frontiers. One of those frontiers was space. It was Kennedy who first vowed to put a man on the moon, and the whole nation was energized. The pioneers at the dawn of the space age took Kennedy's words to heart. They started designing, building, and overseeing the rockets, the satellites, and all the systems necessary to make our country preeminent in space. Everyone knew it would not be easy. In fact, while NASA engineers were helping to put a man on the moon, they often simultaneously felt a sense of awe, wonder, challenge, and accomplishment. By the way, I hope that many of you have seen the film Hidden Figures. Because of that film, now we all know that there were a lot of women and underrepresented minorities who helped play key roles in the success that we achieved. They weren't in the history books when I was in school, but those history books are now being rewritten. And given the outstanding diversity of talent of the Viterbi School, I have no doubt that this class will be writing your own phenomenal chapter for the history books. Today, we have the same opportunity we did in the 60s, that same ability to grasp for a sense of awe, wonder, challenge, and accomplishment in America and around the world. New technology can take us there. Innovative thought can take us there. Inclusivity and acceptance can take us there. But we must use our power as engineers to enhance our world, to overcome the challenges we now face, and to utilize your engineering skills for global good. Today, political situations are changing around the world. Our sense of confidence, our sense of stability, are challenged every day. Even though we are keenly aware of the significance of science and engineering for our health and prosperity, respect and appreciation for fact-based science and engineering is not guaranteed. In addition, during your lifetime, you have witnessed violence in unlikely places against the youngest and most vulnerable among us. I think of Sandy Hook Elementary School, on college campuses, in churches, at airports, movie theaters, holiday parties, public gatherings like the Boston Marathon and the nightclub in Orlando, the Las Vegas concert. Sadly, the list goes on. These are just some of the events that have taken place in the last 6 years, and I know that some of you have personally been impacted. But you have also witnessed unification and healing of communities that could easily have been ripped apart by grief. Where the instigator hoped to provoke negative behavior and undermine our system of justice, but instead provoked strength, compassion, and resolve. We've used our technological prowess to defeat the disruptors and keep would-be foreign and domestic terrorists at bay. I wish I could tell you that these issues and incidents are all in the past, but in fact, I know, as you do, that this is our present, and unfortunately, these challenges will be part of our future. But I can tell you that we are not defined by negative events. We are defined by our response to them. So what does that have to do with you as an engineer with an advanced degree? Let me share a little bit about my personal story and why I became an engineer. I grew up in New York City, in the inner city, in the Bronx, in the projects, in the 60s. No one was coming up to me saying, you know, when you grow up, what you should be is an engineer. There were no engineering role models, no engineering mentors that were telling me that that was possible for me. But my parents understood the value of education, and they knew that that would open doors for me. And as a result, I discovered that what I wanted to do most in the world was to make a difference, to solve relevant problems, and to make things better. And I discovered, oh, by the way, that it's not a bad way to earn a great living as well. It opened doors for me that my parents could not have imagined that I'd be able to walk through. It gave me an outlet for expression, an area of expertise, and a passion for exploration. As a result, I have now become a relentless advocate for STEM education, which I believe is the universal pathway to success. Chuck Vest, a former president of the National Academy of Engineers and a personal mentor, said, "We live in the most exciting era for engineering and science in human history. Engineering is more than the source of solutions for hard problems. It also enables and underpins other disciplines which lead to innovation and a strong economy." And Chuck Vest was right. Engineers understand how and why the world works, and we have the ability to come up with innovative ideas to make it better. Today, you've earned an advanced degree in engineering, but you are also accepting a commitment to be our engaged, informed, critical thinking leaders of the future. It is guaranteed that the world is going to change again. And as you work your way through the infinite possibilities that will create your life story, you'll have new, possibly even conflicting information available to you every day. New leadership opportunities that you can't anticipate will be presented for your consideration, but you're prepared for it. So my advice to you going forward is embrace the change. Look for it. Anticipate it. Prepare for it. And leverage it to get the outcome that you value. Choose to grab the steering wheel and drive the changes necessary to achieve your goals within the complex and changing world that will surround you every day. Perhaps, the biggest contribution you can make is to help make the world a more thoughtful, measured, sensitive, and less polarized place where decisions are research and fact-based. Avoid truth decay. Don't be afraid to speak truth to power. Make certain that your voice is being heard because your ideas are extremely important and well-formulated. You are the leaders, the critical thinkers, who will define the world in the future. Don't look around for someone else to do it, because you are as well prepared as anyone else on the planet to engage and determine what will happen on a global scale. Go and solve the grand challenges. Wherever we are today, as a nation, as a society, as humanity, you have the power to make it better. It's up to each of us, whether we're riding a rocket or not, to travel as far and as wide as we can in pursuit of our dreams. If you're willing to engage, I know that each of you can make a difference on this planet of ours. We desperately need solid, smart, sensitive, and dedicated people in positions of influence and leadership to advance the interests of our society. Class of 2018, we need you. Class of 2018, I applaud you for what you have accomplished and for what you are about to accomplish. Thank you for allowing me to be part of your graduation ceremony, and fight on.